One of the stories Dad talks about is his grandpa was 6 years old when they bought this farm. And he said the first time he come in here with them, with his parents, and when they were moving in, he took one look at that creek, and he said he knew that this is the place he wanted to live.
In the early 1850s, David Thomson, a farmer born in Glasgow, Scotland, immigrated with his family to Canada. He and his wife, Annie Jared, settled in Ancaster, while the rest of the family spread to various locations around Ontario. Among that family was David and Annie's son, James, and his wife, Jane. James and Jane, who married in 1849, purchased land in Ancaster and in Alberton, before finally, in 1869, they bought a property in Onondaga.
James and his wife Jane, they built the house, and they lived here till about 1890. And this house was built, we've got letters that refers to it, they anticipated building the house in 1883, they referred to it being that they're going to build a house. And I think it was probably built in 84, 85. That's when it was completed. That picture upstairs, because it's a picture of all their kids or their grandkids. We figure that picture was taken about maybe in 1892 or 1893. Probably got stored in the attic until Lorna found it.
A couple of years
about
ago.
A year and a half or 2 years ago.
More than 100 years of dust and dirt piled up on it.
But it was okay. In good shape.
The picture was in excellent shape.
You know, that wood's probably 150 years old or more. And a lot of these beams came out of other buildings. That's the way, whoever was building the barn, he'd know where he could get the beams from a barn that was being removed or torn down.
Yep.
He knew what size of beam he had. But they didn't throw stuff away. Like, those timbers were hard to come by even then.
The farm was eventually purchased by James's son, Thomas, who on December 29th, 1886, married Mary Robertson. These certify that Mr. Thomas Thompson of the township of Onondaga, county of Brant, and Miss Mary Robertson of the township of Townsend, county of Norfolk, having appeared before me this day for the purpose of marriage, with dues, certified license, and in the presence of witnesses, and no objections thereto having been made, the said Thomas Thompson and Mary Robertson were united by me in the bonds of holy matrimony, this 29th day of December, in the year of our Lord, 1,886 years, by the undersigned. William Cochran, Minister of Zion Presbyterian Church, Brantford, Ontario. Tom and Mary lived on the farm for many years. In that time, they had four children, Alex, Robbie, Fern, and Walker.
One thing Bill was telling me earlier was that he remembers Tom, his great-grandfather.
I don't remember him here, but I remember him. He lived with his daughter out on Powerline Road, and I can remember going out there and having dinner.
As the years passed, Tom's son Robbie took over much of the farming. But in the spring of 1916, Robbie made a decision to leave home to serve his country in World War I. After enlisting, Robbie served in the Canadian Cavalry and spent 7 months in Western Canada helping with the wartime farming efforts. In 1917, he trained as an officer in the British military. Finally, in 1918, Robbie arrived in France as a member of the British artillery. It was there that he would be stationed for the remainder of the war. France, 17th October, 1918. Dear brother, well, Walker, how is everyone at home? Mother tells me that you have been expecting a letter from me for some time. Well, here you are. I have been most awfully busy during the past 3 months, and have hardly been able to get time to write to Mother, and although I address the letters to Mother, still they are for all at home. We are at rest at last, and have had 6 nice quiet days, for which we are all thankful. We have also moved to a quieter front, and we expect to go into action tomorrow. We were on the front when the greatest advance was made, so you can guess we had some excitement. I am about 2nd on the leave list now, so we'll have 14 days in Scotland soon. I think I will send my sword home, along with a few souvenirs, when I get to England. You see, a sword is of very little use to me. I can use a revolver much better. I have a dandy little Bosch automatic, which I am keeping as a souvenir of one of the biggest advances. I saw a very sad sight yesterday, while out on reconnaissance of roads. I saw a large city that has just been recaptured from the Bosch, and it was absolutely flat, and there was a few French civilians there looking for their homes, but couldn't find one brick on top of another. However, now that we have them pretty well on the run, we are having fairly good buildings to live in at times. Well, Walker, I am very glad that you haven't had to come out, as it isn't any picnic, I can tell you. And you are certainly needed at home, so don't be anxious to join up. One is enough from the family. Everything seems to be going well at present, but I think the war will last for some little time yet, although there are great rumors of peace floating about. Say, how are the melons this year? Mother tells me that someone has been swiping them. I wish I had one. However, we are very well off at present, as we can buy grapes and tomatoes and apples, etc., while out at rest, and we are certainly having some feeds. However, I think we will have it well, as we haven't seen a sign of civilization for the last 3 months, except ruined villages and Bosch dead and prisoners. Well, guess I will have to close for this time. Be sure and write soon. Remember me to all. Your loving brother, Robert. Robbie returned home safely from the war, and in 1921, he married Ethel Evelina Greenwood. Together, they had 2 children, Pauline and Robert Ross Thomson. In 1938, Robbie was traveling to a military reunion in Toronto with 2 friends, RCMP officers James Wishart and Wilfred Lloyd, when their vehicle strayed over the center line and collided head-on with an oncoming bus. Wishart, the driver, and Lloyd escaped with serious injuries, but Robbie died at the scene before paramedics could arrive. He was 44 years old.
Well, we've got 2 fairly good-sized culverts in this laneway, and they drain the what we call the mud run, and it goes around about 130 acres or whatever on the neighboring farm and part of another one, and comes back out here. My dad's father, Robbie Thomson, he put in these 2 culverts. They were boilers, came out of the factory there, and he got a hold of them somehow and put them in, and they're still there, and they're still doing the job. They take a little bit of maintenance once in a while. You got to plug up a few spots where the hatches on the old boilers were, and they were covered over with tin, and the tin's rotted out, so not a big deal. In 1938, Dad's dad, who would be my grandfather, was killed in an automobile accident, and he had been farming here. He was sort of taking it over, but he didn't own the farm. Grandpa Tom still owned it. So when he was killed, Ethel, my grandmother, remarried within a year and moved away. And he moved up to Wingham. And Dad went with her as he was 15. And he got his high school up there. He went to high school up there. This farm was rented out for 10 years because Tom was too old to farm it. So there was lots of people lived here. Butchers lived here. And Ken Campbell and his wife.
Ross, though he grew up in Wingham, kept close ties in Brantford, and in 1943 he married Norma Claire Wilson, a Brantford native who lived in the Alexander Graham Bell homestead. After their marriage, Ross enlisted in the Canadian Air Force, where he served as an electrician in World War II. It was during this time that Ross broached the subject of the farm to his grandfather, Tom.
I believe he wrote and asked his grandfather, when he was overseas in the Air Force during the war, he wrote and asked Tom if he'd be able to buy the farm, didn't he?
Ross returned home safely from the war, and in 1947, he bought the farm from Tom. Also in 1947, Ross and Norma celebrated the birth of their first child, William.
In 1947, Ross and Norma moved down here in June, and I believe Granny and Granddad Wilson stayed here at that time too, didn't they? And Granny's sister Frank and her sister, Norma's sister Peg and her family, when Bill was young, all his first cousins from the Parker family lived here too. So
they lived in the back, that back part. And this milk house was built in the late 50s. There was a wood frame milk house there before, and it'd be my grandfather, my dad's dad. He built that, or because he was starting to ship milk and build up a herd of Holstein cattle at the time, and refrigeration had just, well, come here because they just had the hydro put in 38, and that
was really
the year that he was died in a car accident. And anyway, that unit was still here when I was just a little guy. I can remember it. This used to be the horse stable. And there was four or five stalls, I can't remember. And then there was a wall in there at the end here, and in there there was a big pen where the mares would have their foals if they had to. And but you can, well, you can't see it so much there, but you can't, where that cement is poured, I don't know if it'll show up or not. That's where the horses' back feet were, eh? And they,
oh,
it chewed out the cement from their from their steel hooves. And so you'd have to repair that once in a while, but it shows up pretty good on the far side. They'd go in and out of that door more than this door, because that went into the barnyard. But no, I remember the horses being in here, a pair of horses anyway, and this has been used for many things. It's been Dad had some pigs in it, and we've had young cattle in the barn, and chickens too.
In 1970, Bill married Lorna Gould, and in 1974, Lorna gave birth to their first child, Jennifer. 2 years later, Bill and Lorna welcomed their second child, Laurel. Then in 1982, Lorna gave birth to their third daughter, Hayden.
Bill and I arrived in 1970, and then our children, our three children, make the sixth generation, and when the grandchildren come to visit, they're generation number seven. There were a lot of people lived in this house over the years.